Gleb Alexandrov here, and let's take a look at the Weld modifier and how it can help us to achieve the better modeling workflow. For me, the typical use case would be the Boolean operations and the topology issues associated with them. You can see the minor artifacts caused by the combination of the Boolean and the Bevel modifiers. That's a very common thing, right? And usually we solve these issues by collapsing the modifier stack, jumping into edit mode and removing the redundant vertices or something like that. That's exactly the idea behind the Weld modifier, but it does it procedurally, without us having to sacrifice all our procedural goodies that we have set up. Before that modifier hit the shelves, we were very modest with adjusting the bevel width. It has always been a safer option to keep it low. But now we can actually give it a try and experiment with not so modest bevel widths. Let's see how it works. First, let me isolate this piece by hitting the slash on the numpad. And let's go modifiers and add the Weld modifier. We want to use it solely for fixing the after Boolean topology, so I will place it above the bevel modifier to not accidentally mangle the beveling effects. This mesh artifact is surely caused by the near-miss vertices that lie too close to each other, so by adjusting the distance of the Weld modifier, we can actually merge those vertices. Once again, before the introduction of this modifier, we used to do things manually. Let me try to demonstrate it. I will Shift D to duplicate the mesh, remove the Weld modifier, apply the Boolean modifier, mainly to get access to the mesh data. And now I'll just grab this editable poly, if you allow me a little bit of the 3ds Max terminology, tab into the edit mode, select all vertices by pressing A and then press Alt M, and merge everything by distance. Judging by the prompt at the bottom of the user interface, zero vertices were removed, and that means that no duplicate vertices were found, but we can adjust the merge distance to increase the threshold, the surge threshold. And apparently it's very easy to go over the top with adjusting the merge distance, so it's better to keep it pretty minimal, just enough to remove the most vicious groups of near-miss vertices. So the point is that now we can do the exact same thing, but without collapsing the modifier stack, or without ruining our carefully prepared procedural rig. Well, it doesn't always work as intended. Nothing could beat manual intervention when it comes to really fine adjustments, but it gets the job done, at least in the concepting stage. So let's add the Weld modifier for the second object, position it above the bevel, and carefully adjust the distance. And again, it's very easy to overdo the distance and thus mangle the silhouette too much. And also we have the duplicate limit slider. It limits a number of elements found per vertex, 0 makes it infinite, and honestly I haven't found a reasonable use for it yet, so let's just stick to the default value of 1. Okay, what we can also do is limit the effect to a certain vertex group, and that's it. We have just 3 settings, and I'm sure more will be added later on, when this modifier will be maturing and getting new features over the course of Blender development, but it's already awesome! One more problem we see here is this classic after Boolean artifact. And actually we can try adding the second Weld modifier after the bevel and see how it works. So let me go modifiers, Weld, and carefully adjust the distance, because if we overdrive it, it will start eating the bevel. And we certainly don't want it to happen. So as you can see, at 0.00 something, it hits a sweet spot, where it just removes the problematic issue without touching the rest of the geometry. So yeah, that's pretty much how the Weld modifier can be utilized to enhance the procedural, non-destructive workflow within Blender. I mean the hard surface modeling workflow, of course. It's simple yet elegant, and I think it's already indispensable, at least in the intermediary stages of the hard surface modeling workflow that involves the Boolean cutout operations and stuff like that. Well, great things about modifiers, as opposed to manually dragging the vertices around, is that they are dynamic. You can make adjustments to the original mesh at any time. You can replace the modifiers, move them up and down the modifier stack, and so on. Alright, one more thing that I wanted to show is this use case. So we have a cylindrical shape and we bend it using the simple deform modifier. And unsurprisingly, we see this kind of a seam where the edges of the object meet. Because the simple deform modifier doesn't have any kind of merge checkbox, unlike the array modifier, for example, and previously we have had no practical way of getting around this issue. Well, technically, we could resort to apply the modifiers, but procedurally, there was no way of doing it. And now we can easily tweak it with the weld modifier. So that's pretty much it for this tutorial. Kudos to Blender developers that keep adding the features like this, machine gun style. And if you wish, you can contribute to the development of Blender too, because it's open source. Surprise. My name is Gleb Alexandrov, and you're watching the Hard Surface Modeling update for the 2.8 version of Blender. Drink more coffee.